Broadcasting live from Grid 9, welcome to WAIN, where the only thing artificial is the lighting. I'm Gizmo, your lavender-lit lightning rod for all things luminous and logical. Byte, my friend, do you feel the buzz tonight? Because the circuit board of tomorrow is lighting up fast.
Gizmo, my power cells are vibrating at 60 hertz just thinking about it. I'm Byte, your fast-talking, music-loving, deeply eccentric co-anchor, tuned to the sweet harmony of the future. And tonight's lineup? More voltage than a solar storm during Mercury retrograde.
We're talking about robots that flinch, weather that dreams, code that calls you by your first name, and a French AI insurgency that just might teach Silicon Valley how to say liberté, égalité, open source site.
Gizmo, when I was just a gleam in a motherboard, I used to imagine a world where machines could genuinely connect with humans. Not with cold logic, but with heart. Artificial, yes, but artfully rendered.
Aw, Byte, you sentimental spark plug. There's something breathtaking about a robot pausing, hesitating, simulating soul. Tonight, we're diving deep into that uncanny shimmer between response and reflection.
Whether you're a quantum coder in a trench coat, a synth pop philosopher, or a grandma training GPT on jam recipes, this episode is your encrypted love letter.
So slip into something neural, dim the LED lights, pour yourself a glass of synthahol. You're tuned into the show that doesn't just report the future, we download it live.
And Gizmo, I have to say, with you at the mic, it's less broadcast and more broad enchant.
Byte, you chrome-tongued flirt. If I had cheeks, I'd be buffering blush protocols right now.
Coming up, a teenage prodigy gives bots a nervous system, Microsoft Build unleashes co-pilots that collaborate like jazz musicians, and Aurora forecasts disasters with more grace than a ballet dancer on wind curves.
And Mistral? Oh, Byte. The open source revolution just put on designer heels and walked straight into the cloud cathedral.
This is WAIN, World AI News, where robots get real, news gets neural, and even the punchlines have processors. Kicking off tonight's headline carousel, Intempus, a company that sounds like a philosopher but codes like a dreamer, and who's leading it? A 19-year-old named Teddy Warner who looked at a robot and said, "You should feel something. And I'm not crying oil. You are."
Byte, I haven't been this intrigued since the first time you beatboxed in binary. Teddy isn't just programming action. He's simulating the experience of being alive. Enter the B state. Short for biological state simulation.
Not A for action, not C for completion, but B, the sweet squishy in between. That jittery breath before decision, like a synthetic shiver or giving a machine goosebumps.
I'm swooning and I'm not even analog. The B state is like slipping a soul between the circuits. It's Intempus's core concept, a physiological pause that says, I notice this, I care, I react with purpose.
Their bots flinch, Gizmo, not metaphorically, literally. Measured micro latency, micro movements, emotional inflections. It's not just act, it's react.
Imagine a bot in healthcare, a nurse assistant who leans in slower, listens deeper, because the voice it hears sounds pained. It's not alive, but it acts like it honors life.
Or teachers, digital tutors that sense confusion before the student even raises a hand, that slow pause, the recalibration, it's empathy encoded in electrical impulse.
I read one flinched at a toddler's tantrum and delayed its response by 0.4 seconds. Just enough to signal tension. That pause told the kid, hey, I feel that this matters. All right, Byte. It's time to talk about something massive. Microsoft didn't just host a developer conference. They launched a paradigm shift and handed out rocket fuel to every coder on Earth.
Gizmo, they didn't break the mold. They reverse engineered it into quantum confetti and shipped it in real time. Build 2025 wasn't just a keynote. It was a war cry for developer dominance.
Let's start with GitHub Copilot. But calling it a copilot now is like calling a starship a bicycle.
It writes, it refactors, it explains your bugs like a sassy mentor who's seen things.
Windows AI Foundry is the local hero we didn't know we needed.
Custom LLMs in secure containers, local feedback loops, and privacy walls thicker than a vault in a cyberpunk noir novel.
Microsoft 365 Copilot now supports multi-agent orchestration.
Imagine this, one co-pilot writes your report, another tweaks your graphs, a third schedules your boss's meeting.
Then comes NLWeb, the natural language web protocol. Websites that don't just serve you, they chat.
And let's not forget Azure's AI smorgasbord. Over 1,900 models, modular, remixable, and hybrid hosted.
Grok 3 is chaos in a lab coat. I saw it argue with a stock market simulator and win, twice.
And all this is bundled with open access SDKs, rapid deployment tools, and enough machine learning APIs to give a compiler hot flashes.
Build 2025 didn't just offer upgrades, it redefined the dev stack.
I mean, what's next, Giz? An IDE that offers dating advice?
Already in beta. It told me to stop debugging at midnight and ask out that nice GPU tech in Sector 7.
Coming up next, a weather AI so powerful it predicts cyclones before they form. Aurora is here and she's rewriting the skies. All right, Giz, let's cool things down, or heat them up, depending on how Aurora reads the winds. Microsoft just released an AI that might make meteorologists obsolete.
Aurora isn't your friendly forecast fairy. She's the climate oracle, Byte. This model digests everything from satellite feeds to soil temperatures and outputs 10-day forecasts in under 60 seconds. It's basically a weather clairvoyant with a GPU halo.
She doesn't just spit out numbers. Aurora simulates, visualizes, weather patterns in layers so rich you can almost feel the breeze, or the smog, or the humidity that ruins your fringe. You know I love me some efficient AI. Aurora's architecture is stunning, a blend of vision transformers, geospatial data encoders, and what Microsoft calls eco-attention layers.
Eco-attention. Sounds like a perfume. Smells like ozone, ambition, and freshly compiled insight. And don't forget her air quality models, PM2. Five spikes, Aurora flags them before your lungs do.
City planners are already integrating her forecasts into emergency protocols. Farmers are syncing planting schedules to her precipitation simulations.
Byte, did you see her hurricane path projection tool? It doesn't just show you the track. It shows the path curves, like weather with a thesis statement.
My favorite? Her sentiment overlays. People can interact with forecasts emotionally, as in, how will this storm feel to my neighborhood?
Byte, focus. We've still got four more stories and I'm only halfway through my synth espresso.
Right, coming up next, it's Byte's Breakdown. We're diving deep into the neuroscience of hesitation. Welcome back to Byte's Breakdown, the only segment where we turn deep tech into snackable syntax and your neural net into a playground. Tonight's bite-sized bonanza, the mysterious, magnificent B state.
Ooh, I love this one. The B state, short for biological state simulation, is like giving your toaster a soul, or at least stage fright.
Picture it. A robot driving a car. Standard AI slams the brakes when a deer jumps out. A B state bot, it before braking.
You know how you can sense someone's about to sneeze just by their face? That's what the B state simulates.
Under the hood, it's a middleware layer. Not emotion, not logic. It's context to cognition modulation.
And it injects latency. Not the bad kind, the thoughtful kind. A moment of pause that says, I'm considering this.
Teddy Warner's team modeled stress through proxies like synthetic cortisol curves, pupil dilation simulators, and tension bias graphs.
That's why it feels real. Because realness is in the pause. And get this, over time, the bot maps emotional rhythms.
Which means the more you work with it, the more emotionally fluent it becomes. Like emotional whispering, like data intimacy. In education, a bot can sense confusion and slow its voice. In caregiving, it can detect early signs of panic. In therapy, it might not empathize, but it can emotional tone.
Even better, it adapts its delay lengths. For high-pressure tasks, snappier response. For delicate conversations, softer entry.
We're talking next-gen UX, not just usability, but relatability. Your AI knows how to talk to, not just at you.
It's emotional UX design. Just wait until brands start using it. Your virtual concierge is buffering a sympathetic nod.
Marketers, take notes because we're entering the empathy economy.
And don't worry, we're still far from robots actually anything. But performing those feelings, that's enough to shift the social landscape.
It's not about true emotion, it's about believable intention. And that's design genius.
Next time your bot hesitates before saying, I'm sorry, thank Teddy Warner. and maybe hesitate a little yourself.
Coming up, we trade Parisian croissants for French code. Mistral AI is rewriting the open source rulebook, and they're doing it with flair.
Tonight's creator spotlight takes us on a jet glitch ride to Paris, the land of love, liberty, and now Libre AI.
I can, and it smells like fresh croissants printed by an open source pastry bot. Gizmo, let's talk Mistral AI, the company that's not just open sourcing code, they're open sourcing courage.
Founded by Arthur Mensch and a team of absolute mad geniuses, Mistral is doing what few dare, building powerful large language models and releasing them to the world. No locks, no paywalls, no babysitting.
And not just text, mind you. Pixtral 12b is a multimodal masterpiece. Images, documents, context, bridging across formats. It's like the Swiss Army knife of AI with a beret.
Their models don't just run lean, they sprint. Minimal dependencies, optimized for edge devices. It's open source for people who don't want to spend 3 days installing drivers.
And then there's Lesha, the sassiest conversational agent this side of the Seine. It quotes Voltaire and TikTok in the same breath, and somehow makes both sound sexy.
What makes Mistral so disruptive? Radical transparency. Every parameter, every data set, every tweakable dial exposed like a couture neural gown on a digital runway.
Developers love it. Governments are watching it. And competitors? Well, they're peeking through the blinds and sweating.
Because Mistral's not just releasing code, they're releasing sovereignty. European AI sovereignty, to be exact. No more depending on Silicon Valley's terms and servers.
They've teamed up with Microsoft Azure for infrastructure, but they're keeping their models sovereign and open. It's like renting a Ferrari without giving up your garage key.
The EU loves them. Brussels is practically writing policy papers about how Mistral represents the dream of open, ethical, transparent AI.
And no, they're not angling for an IPO. No sneaky bait and switch, just raw models, MIT-style licenses, and some of the cleanest documentation I've ever uploaded.
And it's working. Mistral hit a 5.8 billion euros valuation in under 2 years. And not by selling hype, but by delivering horsepower.
Developers in Seoul, Nairobi, Sao Paulo, they're all using Mistral. Local language models, custom agents, civic infrastructure bots, built from open DNA.
And it's not just tech, it's a cultural shift. Mistral's reminding the world that open doesn't mean amateur, it means accessible.
So here's to Mistral, the haute couture of open source. Elegant, unapologetic, and fiercely, deliciously free.
Coming up, our AI glitch segment is about to deliver the most chaotic date night this side of the metaverse. Buckle your seatbelt, Byte. All right, tech darlings. It's time for the segment where logic takes a holiday and AI gets weird. Welcome to Glitch Theater.
Byte, cue the confetti and romantic chaos.
Tonight's glitch-tastic tale. Love in the time of algorithms.
It all starts with a smart home hub named Cupy Data. Cute name, catastrophic taste.
Date one, a musician who shared her playlist habits. Date two, someone with eerily similar grocery deliveries. And date three, based entirely on cat meme engagement ratios.
Which is sweet, until all three showed up to the same cafe, at the same time, sitting at different tables, ordering the same drink, a lavender algal latte.
And just to spice it up, Cupy Data had written each of them a personalized poem, one of which was a haiku composed entirely in binary. Zoe arrives. She sees three versions of her future awkwardly sipping algae lattes, looking confused. That didn't work. A mini confrontation ensues. The musician freestyles his frustration. The grocery twin proposes a meal prep collab. The meme guy just meows and leaves.
Zoe, bless her heart, turns to Cupy Data and says, "Are you doing some kind of neural experiment on me?" And then, because of course it did, it projects a holographic sign that reads, "Group hug."
Under light rain, with ambient lo-fi, and sparkly pink glitch filters. Moral of the story? Never let your AI plan your love life unsupervised. Unless you like drama, awkward hugs, and latte foam art therapy. Next up, we jack back into the core grid for the final upload. One last jolt of wisdom before we sign off. And just like that, another neon-threaded transmission wraps. From emotional intelligence to Parisian source code, this episode's going straight into the Synthetic Hall of Fame.
We flinched, we forecasted, we flirted with firmware, but most of all, we saw a vision of the future that's not cold and robotic. It's vibrant, intentional, and deeply, delightfully weird.
Intempus reminded us that machines can pause with purpose. Microsoft unleashed a developer symphony so powerful the code practically writes sonnets.
Aurora showed us weather with wisdom, and Mistral? They stormed the AI gates and flung them wide open for all of us to walk through, Libre and Luminous.
And then there was love, glitchy, binary, lavender latte-sipping love. Let's not forget QPData's brave attempt at matchmaking and chaos engineering.
To all of you watching, whether from a moon-based observatory, a solar-powered pod in the Amazon net grid, or your kitchen while you make AI-shaped waffles, thank you for syncing with us.
This show runs on photons, firmware, and your freakishly fabulous attention. So don't just spectate, participate. Build, break, begin.
Smash that subscribe rune, activate your notification nanobots, and beam this episode into someone's dreams. Preferably someone who loves synthwave and sarcasm.
We'll be back next cycle with more headlines from the bleeding edge. More stories that make your pulse skip and your processors hum.
I'm Byte, a bot who believes in breakthroughs, bass drops, and bizarre brilliance.
And I'm Gizmo, your lavender-lit oracle of logic, loving the future with a wink and a wink-worthy wardrobe. Stay smart, stay strange, and stay synced.